Hello everyone, welcome back to your class. Today we are going to begin with our unit 2, which is Love for Motherland. In this chapter, we are going to read about our brave freedom fighter Subhash Chandra Bose and how we can be the martyrs of our daily life. Now, what are martyrs? Who are martyrs? They are the very people who show their love and respect to their country, even they are ready to sacrifice their lives for the sake of the country. First of all, we will begin with our Netaji, how he has guided us, how he has inspired us all to continue for the freedom struggle which was going on those very days. Netaji was one of the brave freedom fighters, right? He was Subhash Chandra Bose. Once he said, "Give me blood and I'll give you freedom." What does he meant when he said that? What he meant was, only if we, the people, are ready to sacrifice their lives for the sake of their nation, only then we will get our freedom. He was born on January 23rd, 1897. And since the childhood itself, he was very intelligent and a disciplined child. After completing his college education, he went to England and passed the civil services examinations with the merit. But when the very news of the Jallianwala Bagh massacre reached him, he was very much disturbed at that time. At that time, he decided that he will leave his civil services training midway and he returned to India in 1921. After returning from England, he formed his own party so that he could participate and fight against the British. What was that party's name? The Forward Bloc. He then went to Germany and Japan to seek their cooperation against the British and formed the Indian National Army, the INA. But unfortunately, INA couldn't win against the battle against the British. So on August 17, 1945, it is believed that Netaji died in a plane crash while flying from Bangkok to Tokyo, and unfortunately he didn't live to see India's independence. But his life, his struggle, his spirit still continued to inspire so many people. It continues to inspire us that we have to protect our motherland, we have to love our motherland as we love our own mother. Being a motherland, our country always protects us. It showers its love. So in return, we should also respect our country and should show our love to our motherland. Now the very next question is, how we can become the martyrs of the daily life? It is not at all necessary that only by fighting in the wars, going to the jails, we can be the martyrs of the life, martyrs of our country. No, by fulfilling our responsibilities in the little tasks also, we can become the martyrs of the daily life. How we can see this? By loving our country, its culture and its people. By loving our motherland as we love our own mother, by treating it our mother only. By respecting the national flag, national anthem. By celebrating important national events like Independence Day and Republic Day. And the very best way how we can prove our love for our country is, we can try to free our nation from corruption, caste system, poverty, violence, inequalities, discriminations, all the things, which is letting back our nation. It is not letting our nation to develop. So the best way to prove our love for our motherland is, let our actions prove the depth of our love for the nation. We all know that actions speak louder than words. So we should fulfill our responsibilities to show our love for our motherland. Please try to read your unit 2. Thank you.